Hey guys, so today we are going to learn about SPAC lines, how to use SPAC lines in Excel. So let's get started. Okay, so this is your data, which is in positive, negative, and quarterly basis of various months. And you want to display this data in SPAC lines. Okay, so let's say this is the area wherein you want to display it. Okay. So what you need to do is select the area first, click insert, then select SPAC lines. So it will ask you for the date range. What is the date which data range for which you want to consider? Okay, so I will say this is the data range and the location is from year to year. So I'll press OK and this will create the SPAC lines over here. So please, if you note, if I just squeeze it out or if I just move around the SPAC lines, data which is being represented, that is being changed visually. Okay, so apart from this, you can also keep your first point, low point, when did your data or sales hit high point or low point, negative points. Okay, then you can also have markers for each month which you are having. Over here, if you move, then you can have more colors if you want to display. Then this line which has been displayed, you can click this and change the color or the line font which you want, which is getting displayed. Okay, so another way, another thing is if you want negative points in red color, then you can specify red color. Then if you want high point in blue color, you can specify blue color. And in different ways you can see this data. Okay, so if you have different choices over here, you want to show it in a different color format, you can always select those data over here. Now if you are not, sometimes you want to increase the height in order to see this data properly, so you can always, you know, increase the height. Okay, I will just remove this columns. Now if you see, the data is being represented visually in a different way. Okay, but the data is the same. So you can also keep the axis over here, so that if you click on axis, then show axis, then it will show you data which is below the negative range. Okay, when the sales dropped negatively, that means you have excess of sales limit at the town line. Okay, with comparison to previous year. Okay, now if you want to display this SPAC lines in a different way, you can just click on this column, and if you see, this data is being represented different way. Okay, now this coloring is based on this sequence which you select. But if you note over here, is since I have kept the base over here as 100, okay, that's why it will be showing me data in a different, in the same manner. So if you have some data over here, let's say equal to this into 2, okay, I will repeat this till here. Control X, Control V. Sorry, Control X, and then I will paste. I will paste it over here as values. Okay. So if you see now, there is no bigger difference if I have, if you see at the column width. Okay, so this, the highest in this row is 200. Okay, 200 is over here, the highest in this row is 100. If some sales analyst is viewing this data, he won't be able to analyze this based on this data. Okay, so if you want the base over here to be of of a same range, then what you need to do is, again go to design, axis, then same for all lines, then over here also same for this. That means maximum and minimum value will be the same for all the lines. So if you see now, this has got decreased and this has got increased. So this is a way wherein you can always show your data. You want to see only the negative and positive way, then you can just click this button. It will show you data whether it is negative or positive. Okay, so this pack lines, if you see this data in a proper way, then you can see and analyze data in much better way. So I will just give you an example. Let's say you are having this quarter one, quarter two over here also. Okay, I have just pressed the control key. Okay, and now if you want to display data over here in Sparkline style, just go to insert and click this, and your data will be this one. Okay, and location range will be this one. Okay, press okay. Okay, so you don't need to, you will just have to select this part, and then where is the insert button, insert, then select the date range, come on, then select the location range, come on, and done. Shit, yeah. Get the date range which you will have to select is this one, data range, and the location range will be from here to here. I put July. Are yeah, what is happening? Location is not valid. Why? Okay, I got it. This data range will be this, location range will be this. Okay, yes, finally. Okay, so this is the data. I will just move it across and merge and center. Do the same for others also. Oops. Okay, so this is your data which needs to be checked upon. So you can always click on different points, high point, end point, low point, negative point, markers, then you can change the color also. Okay, and that is the way you can work on it. Okay, so that was it for the day. If you like this video, just give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel with the notification bell.